Bonjour. In today's video, we are going to talk about direct object pronouns. Let's do some unpacking of the title and start with object. It is the part of a sentence, usually a noun, noun phrase or pronoun, that is affected by a verb's action. Then we have direct object. It is created, affected or altered by the action of a verb. It is called direct because it is not connected to the verb by any preposition. For instance, j'ouvre la fenêtre. I'm opening the window. And finally, we have pronoun. It is a type of word that replaces a noun or a noun phrase. It is used mainly to avoid repetition. For instance, cet homme s'appelle Pierre. Il a 30 ans. This man is called Pierre. He is 30 years old. Il is a pronoun, and I use it to avoid repeating cet homme. Note that s apostrophe is also a pronoun, a reflexive one. In a nutshell, the direct object pronoun is a pronoun that replaces the direct object of a verb. It is never connected to the verb by a preposition, and like any pronoun, it agrees in gender and number with the noun that it replaces. For instance, je regarde Pierre, je le regarde. I am watching Pierre, I am watching him. Je ferme la fenêtre, je la ferme. I'm closing the window, I'm closing it. The direct object pronouns are at the first person singular, me or m apostrophe before a vowel or a silent h, me, second person singular, te or t apostrophe, you, third person singular masculine, le or l apostrophe, third person singular feminine, la or l apostrophe, him, her, it. First person plural, nous, us. Second person plural, vous, you. Third person plural, les, them. Note that the direct object pronouns le, la, les and l apostrophe are identical to the definite articles. When they are followed by a noun or an adjective and a noun, they are definite articles. For example, je lis le livre, I'm reading the book, livre is a noun. But when they are followed by a verb, they are direct pronouns. For instance, je le lis, I'm reading it, lis is a verb. In English, the direct object pronouns, like the noun phrase, is placed after the verb. For instance, I am watching Pierre, I am watching him. However, in French, the direct object pronoun is placed before the verb. For instance, je regarde Pierre, but je le regarde. At the negative form, the direct object pronoun is placed between ne and the verb. For instance, je ne le regarde pas, I am not watching him. At the passé composé, the direct object pronoun is placed between the subject and the auxiliary. For instance, je l'ai regardé, I watched him. Please note that the past participle used with the auxiliary avoir agrees in gender and number with the direct object pronoun. For instance, j'ai regardé cette fille, je l'ai regardée. I watched this girl, I watched her. At the negative form of the passé composé, the pronoun is placed between the ne and the auxiliary. For example, je ne l'ai pas regardé, I did not watch him. At the imperative, the direct object pronoun is placed after the verb. For instance, regarde-le, watch him. And for the first and second person singular, we use the disjunctive pronoun. For instance, regarde-moi, watch me. However, at the negative form of the imperative, we use the normal direct object pronoun and it is placed before the verb. For instance, ne me regarde pas, don't watch me. And finally, with a modal verb, pouvoir, vouloir and devoir, and the infinitive, the direct object pronoun is placed before the infinitive, not the modal verb. For instance, tu veux boire le soda? Oui, je veux le boire. Do you want to drink the fizzy drink? Yes, I want to drink it. Bon travail, au revoir. Created using Powtoon.